This Is Your Life was a very popular TV series. And the crowning moment was when Eamon Andrews presented the person with the red book. I can only imagine if Eamon Andrews and television were available in 19th century Italy, his research team would have had a relatively easy task sourcing material on Don Bosco. It's the editorial crew who would have had the headache of trying to produce a 30-minute show. On the other hand, if Eamon Andrews decided to present a show on Don Bosco's mother, Mama Margaret, as she was affectionately known, his research team probably would have been put to the pin of their collars to obtain sufficient material. Her life seemed to be so ordinary. And yet, it is in this that her heroism and holiness lies. No doubt, the show would touch on the fact that she was widowed at the age of 29, that she faced the hardship of poverty, legal court cases with her landlord, and caring for her sickly mother-in-law, a stepson Anthony, and her own two sons, Joseph and John. The three boys could not have been less like each other. She was gentle with them, yet assertive, because her children were not always easy to manage. Anthony refused to accept her authority. "You're just my stepmother." How that remark used to sting her, as well as his domineering of Joseph and John. Psychologists might be quick to suggest that Anthony was probably suffering from the traumatic experience of the deaths of both his parents. Anthony just could not understand John's desire to study. After all, why should John, after learning the three R's, want to study more at the family's expense? Margaret did not agree with Anthony on this, as she had already come to the decision that John must continue his studies, possibly with the priesthood in mind. After a period of mounting tension, Margaret took the heartbreaking decision of sending the 12-year-old John away from home to look for work. It is interesting to note that Don Bosco does not record this in his memoirs. Perhaps he felt that this might reflect badly on his family. Or was the experience so traumatic for him at the onset of adolescence that he relegated it to his subconscious? Be that as it may, Don Bosco saw himself particularly called to work for orphaned and deprived young people. Out of his own personal experience, he was irresistibly attracted to them and developed a deep understanding of their plight. Without doubt, the show would also zone in on the conversation that John had with his mother following 4 months of convalescing, when she had nursed him back to health from what we might now call burnout. He asked her, at the age of 58 years, which was considered old at that time, to leave her home, her grandchildren, the familiar countryside of the Becky, and move to the squalid northern outskirts of the industrial city of Turin to help him look after the boys in Valdocco. Her reply, "If you think such a move is God's will, I am ready to go now," echoes the words of another woman whom Margaret had a great love for. a love she inculcated in her children. Be it done unto me according to your word. Two women of rock solid faith. Mama Margaret spent the last 10 years of her life caring for the youngsters in the Valdocco Oratory as her own, and they accepted her and loved her as their mother. They called her Mama, just as Don Bosco did. Her position was not merely that of a domestic help, but she clearly plays an active role in the educational method which Don Bosco wanted to create in his houses and centres. That family atmosphere which becomes a privileged means of passing on values. Don Bosco himself acknowledged that much of his teaching and practice was based on her example. This poor, unlettered woman had a subtle sense of education. Mama Margaret, you are a valiant woman. Your life, the way you raised the Bosco boys, the way you fostered and supported John's vocation, and the climate of dedication and kindness you helped create in Valdocco bears powerful testimony to the heroism and holiness hidden in the concrete demands of daily life. Mama Margaret, this is your life.